Hello everyone. Today we will learn code rules which are very important in RDBMS. So you must be aware about Dr. Code. He laid the foundation of RDBMS and he provided number of rules that are basis for all modern RDBMS. Let us see the rules one by one. So in all there are 12 rules, but beside these 12 rules there is rule number 0. Now why this rule number 0? This rule number 0 is a bit tricky. What does it say? That how much advanced and any RDBMS may become, but it should not go outside the RDBMS rule. It means whatever has to be done, it has to be done through its relational capabilities only. This you will come to know after all the rules are completed. We can define it in this way also, that rule number 0 says that the database must be relational, completely relational, and nothing but relational. What does it mean? Let us see it one by one. First of all, rule number 1. Because of this rule, the tables are created, in very simple words. This rule says that in DBMS, or in other words in RDBMS, the data can be kept only in one way, by values in the table within a particular column for a particular row. It means that this type of arrangement is because of this rule number 1. It says that whatever value is to be stored is to store in a particular column for a particular row. In other words, whatever value will be stored, it will be stored in the form of column values or in the form of rows. Okay, this is simple rule number 1, which means that data should be kept only in the tables. Rule number 2, guaranteed access rule. Now what does this rule says? This rule says that any piece of information should be accessed without ambiguity. Now what is this ambiguity? It means even if you want to see a single piece of information, you should be able to see with the help of table name, primary key and column name. Now what does it mean? Now suppose if you want to see the city of Kumar, so how you can see? Very easy. You can type select city from student where roll number equals to 6. So what we have used in this query? We have used a table called student. We have used a where condition column, that is roll number, and what we have to see is given after select. So if you type this query, you will see Kanpur. So it means this Kanpur is atomic data. Atomic means out of this collective data, this is a single value. So if you want to see a single value, it should be able to display it. So you must remember during this entire tutorial that whatever in SQL is happening, it is because of these rules. These rules came first, then on the basis of these rules, SQL was created. So please be very clear that SQL is behaving like this because of these rules. Okay, so you might feel it very simple that it is very easy. It is easy because of this rule. Okay, so you either you can see selectively or you can see collectively like this. Okay, this was rule number 2. Now rule number 3 is important: systematic treatment of null value. Now what does this rule says? That your RDBMS should support null values. Now a null value should not be something like space or an empty string in quotes or a zero or something else. Null means null, which means that something like this. These values are neither zero, neither empty string. They are simply as null. So RDBMS has very important handling functioning of null values. Now let us see some example how to handle null values, because sometimes null values can create number of problems. Now suppose if you type select sum balance from student, what you will see? You will see balance has come. Okay, now if you try to type select average balance from student, now it has come 500. Now see, at a first glance it may look correct, but if you see that the rows are 8, and if you divide 2500 by 8, 500 will not come. It means what happens, sometimes you will not come to know, but your answer may not be correct, because the average should be the total number of values, considering that these are considered as zero, but Oracle by default doesn't take them as zero. So your average has come as 500, although it should come as select 2500 by 8 from dual. If you try to do this, it should have come 312.5, but it has come 500. It is because of these null values. So handling null values is very important. So sometimes what you want, that these null values should be converted into some any other temporary value. So what you can do, you can use a function called as nvl. So what you will type, select nvl, suppose balance comma zero from student. Now see what will happen. Wherever it will find value of balance, it will show that, but wherever it will find null, it will replace by this value. So you can see, wherever it was 500, it has shown as it is, but wherever it was null, it has displayed you zero. You can use any other value also. For example, you can type it as minus 10 from student, it will give minus 10. So now if you want to take out correct average, what you will do, temporarily you will replace these null values by zero so that they come into the function. So what you will type, select average of what? First of all, NVL of balance comma zero from student. So what you can see, now correct answer has come. So whenever you want to use your null values in any function, please be very careful that if you don't consider them, they can give you wrong answer. So you can use this NVL function to replace it with any value. This NVL function can also be used in alphanumeric columns. It is useful in any type of column. Okay, so let us move to the second part of video, and next rule we will see in next video. Thank you.